Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I welcome all of you to IGSA Holi Night 2015. I'm sure you are all excited about tonight's performances. We surely are. We have. Awesome. So, when we think about Holi, the one thing that I love about Holi as a festival is that it comes with a disclaimer. And that is bura na mano holi hai. It means don't mind, it's just holi. You can put colors on whoever you want. You can be casual, carefree, playful. It's a very casual festival. And whoever has celebrated Holi would know what I'm talking about. So tonight's performances and whatever I speak would be with the theme of bura na mano holi hai. My job is to make tonight a very memorable evening for all of you. We have a lot of performances coming up. If every art form is a color, we have a rangoli for you. If every dance form or music is a color, we have a rangoli for you, a mix of colors tonight. And we will start with some basic colors, some fundamental colors. We will go on and add some creative hues as we go along with tonight's performances and end with beyond your imagination, psychedelic mixture of colors. So I'm sure you are all excited. So without saying a word more, let me welcome you. Well, let me welcome the first performance of the evening, the Indian classical dance performance. Thank you.
In praise of Lakshmi, the Indian goddess of prosperity and fortune. This Kirti, composed by Purandara Dasa, starts off by calling out to goddess Lakshmi to visit the houses of her devotees and bless them with good fortune. It goes on to describe the beautiful sound of the jingling anklets heard by saints, worshipping her as she slowly steps into their homes. She is called the giver of infinite prosperity, the lotus-eyed goddess with the shining golden bangles on her wrists and the auspicious vermilion kumkum on her forehead, who is the elegant consort of Lord Venkateshwara. It ends by calling out to her, the queen of Purandara Vithala, to grace the homes of her devotees as they worship her. We present to you Bhagada Lakshmi in Ragam Madhyamavati and Talam Adi with the choreography by Srimati Lata Rajesh.
Thank you.
What blows my mind is the fact that these dance forms are more than 2,000 years old. I mean, just think about it. If these dancers could travel back in time, 2,000 years back, they would be still relevant. People would still get these dances. I mean, for all we know, people like Arjun, Bhim, they would be talking about these girls. Like, have you seen these girls? Oh my God. Arjun would be telling Bhim, I love these girls. The new moves that they've come up with, oh my God, it's awesome. And Bhim would be like, yeah, dude, I listen to the music all the time while working out. I love that. But on a serious note, this is a tradition that is more than 2,000 years old. So let's give them a big hand for keeping this tradition alive. After the dance performance comes the Indian classical music. Even the Indian classical music can trace its root back to Vedas, which are like the oldest books ever written. And they are also more than 2,000-3,000 years old. All the music that comes out of India are basically based on these ragas and roots that were written thousands of years ago. So let me take you through this journey of Indian classical music. Welcome the band.
Good evening, everyone. We welcome you to the Holi night, and it's our pleasure to present to you Jalatarangam, Veena, and Violin combination on this stage for the first time ever. And to start off with, we're going to start with a Varnam in Ragam Hamsadvani. For those of you who would like to keep count, we're going to play that in Adithalam. And we're going to showcase two speeds of the same Varnam to begin with, and then we'll finish with the fastest speed. That'll be the first piece of the day. Thank you. The second piece would be a Western note. It's called the English Notes, and we'll be presenting to you with these three Indian instruments. It's inspired from Western music, obviously, so it's not based on any particular raga, but hope you enjoy it.
So how was that? I was really mesmerized by that performance. I've never heard what I would like to think of a xylophone, like a xylophone on stage ever before, and it was amazing. Now next we have is a light music performance, and as you can see they're setting it up. So let me talk about a little bit about music, evolution of music in India. As you just saw, the classical music, Indian classical music, is very old. The ragas and the rules are historic. And over a period of last 2,000 or 3,000 years, those rules have remained the same, and based on those rules and ragas, different songs are composed. Now with Bollywood, those classical rules and ragas got modified or transformed, and people started experimenting with those, and it became a fusion with different Western music and all that to take a new form. And that's how Bollywood music has evolved over years. And today in India, music means pretty much Bollywood music. To take you through the evolution of Bollywood music, I have a small piece of what I would like to call Bollywood beatbox. And let me take you through Bollywood from 50s to 2000s. So don't forget to clap, okay? The songs started, some of the songs were like this. This was 50s. Then came 60s and 70s, romantic songs like This was 70s, 60s, 70s. And then came the era of discos with songs like this was 80s. The 90s came the era of A.R. Rahman with songs like influence of Western music. One of my favorite songs is To take you through voices that has happened in Bollywood, let me give you some examples of the singers that have come to Bollywood music. We all of us know the conventional hit singers, like in yesteryears it was the trio of Mukesh, Kishore, and Rafi. But there have been some unconventional singers in Bollywood. One of the first unconventional singers that I found in Bollywood was Hemant Kumar. He has a very distinct voice, very distinct style of singing. But when he's, I mean, hearing his voice, I felt as if he didn't move his lips at all while singing. His voice was something like this. No movement. Then came era of Mohammed, the Rafi, Kishore Kumar, Mukesh, and all that. So, I mean, we have heard them a lot. Some of the unconventional singers I'm talking about here, like, for example, Bappi Lahiri. He was a music director turned singer. And he also had a very distinct style of singing. How I observe Bappi Lahiri, if he has to say ah, he will say air. His mouth opens like this, not like this. So the songs become this. This was Bappi Lahiri. In '90s, the competition really opened up. A lot of singers. The unconventional ones were a wonderful singer from Eastern India, Bhupen Hazarika, and his voice was extremely different. His voice was something like this. Bhupen Hazarika. There was one other singer who was my favorite, very unconventional style of singing, Remo Fernandez. Remo Fernandez was something like this. Oh, baby, money, chocolate, baby, 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 thank you. I think you're ready. Thank you. Can you hear me? Can you turn on the instruments on? There's nothing on our monitors. Yep, still nothing. Can you hear me? Awesome. Okay, everyone, how are we doing tonight? That's it? A little more, come on, there's like 300 of you out there. Yeah, I like this guy over here, he's got enthusiasm. Okay, this is the night music segment, as you all would know. And our first song, since we're a little late of time, no real introductions right now. Our first song is called Ruk Aa Gaye Re from 1947 Earth. And Ashik, take it away.
Hi, can you hear me? Ruk Aa Gaye Re, you raised the vocals on the monitors?
Hello.
Can we have everyone clapping for this? One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. With us! Thank you. How's that? Alright, the next song is not going to be a cover. We're going to do an original composition. Other people who have attended before would know that we usually do one or two every time. And I will hand it over to one of the main composers, Ashik, to introduce the song.
Hello everyone, this is the first time we are going to perform this song. So this song is action composed for you guys. I hope you like it. A special credit for this song should go to Skype and Google Hangout, because the words were written with someone from Mumbai, and the singer was actually, he drove all the way from Boston to sing the song. So here is Shubham Kalyan. We went to the same undergrad college, and once you hear the song, I think you will be able to figure out why we actually needed such a famous classical singer to sing this song. So over to Sumit Kalyan.
Am I audible? Thank you.
चांदी डेरा है अब ले जाएगी कहाँ मिट्टी की खुशबू आए पलकों पे आंसू लाए पलकों पे रह जाएगा यादों का चाहा मंजिल नहीं है अनजाना है कारबार चलना अकेले है on percussions. Arna Devnath on vocals. A lot of you would know Ashay Khudavaksh on vocals and guitar. He's been playing for really long time with us now. Thanks a lot, Ashay. We've got Deepan Pal on percussion. We've got Kanish Ghosh on guitar. We've got Sumedh Deknalkar on guitar. We've got Vinay Palakot on vocals. And it's Vinay's last time as well. He's been playing with us since last Holi. So give a round again for Vinay, please. Great guy. And we've got Siddharth Sidhu Singh on keyboard. And he plays all instruments, but this time just the keyboard. Give it up for him. And my name is Shubhaditya. Hope you have a wonderful evening. Thank you guys.
So that was Light Music, which was Bollywood and non-Bollywood Indian music. How did you like it? A lot of effort, amazing performance. So Bollywood has been affecting a lot of Indian music. There used to be a time when there was Indian classical music and there was a pop scene also, but it kind of vanished, kind of merged with Bollywood music. You got some glimpses of Bollywood music today itself. Sometimes I think, what if Bollywood music could influence world music, different genres? How would it be? So if there was like a song, Jaane Jaa Dhoondta Phira, for example, how would it be if the same song was taken into different music styles and adapted? So the tune, something is like, Jaane Jaa Dhoondta Phira. If the same song was taken up by, for example, it's the Chinese singers in China, how would it be? Something like, adapted to Bollywood style. The same song went to Caribbean music. How would it be? Something like this. If the same song went to opera, how would it be? So female singers. Male singer. So Bollywood can influence world music. And now, before I take too much time, our next performance is a fusion between Indian classical and Western music. So please welcome Indian Classical Dance 2.
Traditionally choreographed and performed on Carnatic classical music and enjoyed by knowledgeable connoisseurs. However, in today's day and age, this dance form has adopted a neoclassical outlook, wherein the purity of gestures and movements are preserved, but it is choreographed on westernized music that is appealing to the masses, thus successfully capturing the essence of the dance while bringing it into the modern era. Today, we present to you one such performance comprising of two songs. In the first song, we depict all the nuances of the graceful and proud peacock adapted from a choreography by Dakshina Vaidyanathan. The second song is Swans of Saraswati, composed and rendered by the band Agam, portraying Nritya of pure dance, consisting of beautiful gestures and complex foot movements. The concept and choreography for this was adapted from a performance by Nitya Narasimhan and Shrimati Murali.
Thank you.
revival is a fusion between Indian classical and Western music with the classical dance. I'm sure you loved it. Before I forget, I want to remind you again that please throw the trash into the right bin. There are compostables right here. The plates that you ate your samosas in are compostable, so please throw them in the compostable bin. If you don't, there are people who will do that sorting for you and just make their life easy. Thank you. Our next performance is by a CMU dance group called Tana. So they're going to present a fusion dance performance. So welcome them with a big hand. Pretty sure you have enjoyed the show so far, and what we have is our last performance of the day, but a grand one. It's a dance drama, and it's based on our favorite topic, Bollywood. Have you ever wondered how Bollywood creates record number of movies every year, year after year? It's the most prolific film industry in the world. It does that because it has a lot of ideas. Not just on its own, but we get ideas from all across the world. We don't discriminate. We take ideas from Hollywood, we take ideas from Asian film industry, we take ideas from European film industry. We don't discriminate at all. But if you think that we plagiarize, think again, because Bollywood has a fixed format. And taking any story and converting into a Bollywood movie is not a simple task. Even if the movie is about just plain revenge action, we have to take it, get a heroine in the story, we have to add 5 songs, 1 item number, 2-3 emotional scenes, and then we have a Bollywood movie. So it's a tough task. A Hollywood actor is just a Hollywood actor, but a Bollywood actor is a dancer, is a lover, is a fighter, so much. it's easier to get into NASA than become a Bollywood actor. And this story is our tribute to the formula films of Bollywood. Everything is fair, as long as it fits the formula. So, tonight, we hope that when you see this performance, you would feel that you are watching a Bollywood movie, sitting in theater, screaming out loud, standing up on the seat, dancing, screaming, whatever you want. Everything is a fair game. Bura na mano, holy yet. Arun, can we have a sound check before we start?
The engineer is a small bipedal humanoid.
Cool. We can cut it.
Characterized by its buck teeth.
All right. So with that,
the engineer is a small bipedal.
With that, I'm going to go. Enjoy the performance. Have fun.
Man wanted to become Mukaddar Ka Sikandar, and every son had an Andhi Ma without a father. This was the time of high drama, revenge sagas, and epic romances, when couples used to run around trees proclaiming their love.
तुहार नाम का है? What is your name?
Myself, मैं जयंती माला मालिनी. And यार good name?
Our heroines used to be shy, and our heroes shy.
Thank you.
This was also the time when if two flowers touched, children were born.
बच्चन खन्ना का बबुआ बहुत बड़ा इंजीनियर बनेगा।
नहीं, मेरा बेटा बहुत बड़ा एक्टर बनेगा। यू, ठीक, गो चेंज इस डायपर।
वैजयंती माला मालिनी एंड देव बच्चन खन्ना नेम्ड देयर सन हरिश्चंद्र बच्चन खन्ना माला मालिनी उर्फ हैरी। Harry was growing up fast and was unusually bright for a child his age.
Harry, beta, apni mummy ke pair chuo. Beta, mummy ka apne report card ko dikhao.
Maths mein.
But the landscape of Bollywood had changed. The number of dances per movie was increasing, and so were the tourism revenues of Switzerland. This was also the time when the self-proclaimed Generation X was becoming rebellious. They wanted to do something different, pursue their passions. In other words, something which their parents didn't want them to do.
Harry, beta, where are you? What are you doing?
I was just doing some maths for college.
How many times have I told you, all these maths and physics classes, they will take you nowhere. Have you heard of any maths guy who earns crores in a soap commercial?
But mom.
Just look at Sharma ji's son. He earned the role of a foot soldier. In one of Mahabharata's fight scenes, he was on the screen for 6.28 seconds.
Oh, you mean 2 pi seconds?
Shut up! Look at you! What have you done?
But Maan, this is not what I want to do.
What is it that you want to do?
I want to differentiate. I want to do surface integrals. I dream of numbers when I sleep.
Chee! यही देखने के लिए तुझे पाल पोस के बड़ा किया? After your father vanished, I worked so hard. For whom? For you. With so much hope, I admitted you to Sergeant Khan's overacting classes and Sunny Deol's dancing classes. Dancing classes. To see this day? Chee! इससे पहले मैं मर क्यों नहीं गई?
But माँ, 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 अच्छा wait. माँ, माँ, मैं करूँगा acting. I'll become an actor. रो मत, माँ, रो मत. मैं करूँगा acting. And one more thing. I love this girl called Simran.
What? Really?
It's okay. I'll forget her. It's fine. रो मत, माँ, रो मत. I'll forget her.
बेटा, ये आंसू नहीं. खुशी के आंसू हैं। This is the most filmy line you have ever said, son. I'm proud of you. चलो, let's go do some DDLJ.
What's DDLJ?
ढक्कन। दिलवाले तुम्हें यहाँ ले जाएंगे। चलो।
Yeah.
a story without a love story. Because Bollywood. So the hero's mom approves this, but it can't be so simple. It is not. So here comes the girl's dad, Amrish Nath from Alok Puri. Amrish does not approve of the union because hashtag sanskar. So here comes the other guy, the chosen groom. Prem Khan. He is shy, successful, and sanskari. That ticks all the boxes. Initially, the girl is like, no way! But by the interval of the movie, she's like, bande mein kuch to baat hai. And then comes the climax, the big dilemma. Which guy will the girl choose? Bollywood was evolving. New age, new characters, but the plot remained the same. Exactly the same. So this is a story about a girl. She is pretty. She is charming. Sometimes obstinate, always confused, and has a bunch of friends who excel at giving her wrong advice. But gone are the times when the hero had to be chained to make Basanti dance. This is the era of women empowerment. This is the time when Basanti dances because she wants to. Well, actually, because Farah Khan wants her to. it can't be only about the girl. We need a male lead, or two, or three. But let's stick with two, because love triumphs. Here comes Sikar Dhawan, son of Daddy Dhawan. He is adventurous in just one song. He has big ambitions in life and wants big things in life, and they all do because Bollywood. And they fall in love. It could be a slow and gradual process. Usually not, they fall in love instantly because you need to fit 10 songs plus 2 item numbers in the story. So, love at first sight, which practically means love at first song. So, this story is about a hero, a heroine, and a villain. But our villain, Sag Malhotra, is not entirely villainous because he is a popular actor. He is actually a good guy with whom bad things had happened. And he is out there for money or revenge, or money for revenge. But before the revenge, he must complete the minimum number of dances required. Because Bollywood.
Get off the stage.
Zombies are hugely misunderstood creatures. They are basically like grad students. Both are sleep deprived. They are at their peak post midnight. And most importantly, what free food is to grad students, brains are to a zombie. Rebuilding their image, which was tarnished by recent Hollywood movies. 90% मिल के कैंसर
ये इंटरमिशन है। इस इंटरमिशन के दौरान मैं आपको अपनी कहानी सुनाना चाहता हूँ। मेरा नाम अमरीश है। मैं पिछले 50 सालों से रोज गुटका चबाता रहा हूँ। सिमरन तो अपनी जिंदगी जीने चली गई, लेकिन शायद मेरी जिंदगी छोटी रह जाएगी। मुझे कैंसर हो गया है। कहते हैं मैं ज्यादा दिन जिंदा नहीं रहूंगा। बेटा मेरी तरह मत बनना, वीको वज्रदंती का इस्तेमाल करना।
In the year 1975, when Bollywood was in its langour, Hollywood was being attacked by mysterious creatures of the third kind. But they were stopped by some greater force. The attacks kept coming and they got hungrier. They would not be content with our brains. They wanted bheja fry. Hence, they infiltrated Bollywood. However, Bollywood remained ignorant and continued doing choti choti baatein in bade bade desh.
trouble. I'm all going by that bass, no trouble.
Divided they fall and united they stand, or simply one plus one is 11. Well, almost. Because zombies, aliens, and dogs like us follow binary. They joined forces to form the Injustice League with one and only one objective. Conversion of all mankind. They wanted to take over planet Earth. Mankind was lucky till now, since Will Smith, Tom Cruise, and Shaktiman managed to fight them off one at a time. But against this menage a trois of evil, even they cower now. Our MC was the first to witness their rot. But that was just them making a statement. Kyunki picture abhi baki hai mere dost. MC was the first casualty in this war, but he surely won't be the last.
Attacks have been reported in Tunisia, India, and Japan. Curfew has been called in all states of matter, in land, air, and water. The penguins of Madagascar and Antarctica are putting up a brave fight, but they are going down soon. I know this is a cliched line, but this may be the end of humanity as we know it.
All hope might not be lost. Recent evidences support that there might be a prophecy which speaks of a certain one. I repeat, a certain one who can save us all.
Some are day and some are night. You, however, are twilight. To make sure tomorrow comes your way, heed what I say, come what may. Because 1 plus 2 is 2 plus 1. You alone can ensure the deed is done. To have your cake and eat it too. Do to them what they did to you.
Namaskar, Devyo Sajru. Cameron and Dandam Pata ke saath mein reporter Deepak Chavasiya reporting live. Aap dekh rahe hain Kalka. Sanchari Desh khabar de rahe hain aapko raat bhar. Aaiye yahan par maujood kuch logon se unki pratikriya lete hain.
Inshallah, the voice played very well.
So then,
all by myself? Is mankind doomed once and for all? Or is there one who can save us all?
We call them Zab, zombies, aliens, vampires, and hashtag Zab is trending on Twitter.
Hashtag the one will save us all.
अबे तेरा ध्यान किधर है तेरा दीवान किधर है शिकार दीवान
yeah! I can save them all.
Who's the hell are you, madam?
I am Vaidyanti Mala Malini and I am the one. Let us not waste any more time in me denying me my destiny, just to add more drama to the story. I am the one because I shall strike thee with great vengeance. I have unraveled the prophecy. The prophecy says 1 + 2 = 2 + 1. What it really means is 1 2 ka 4. 4 2 ka 1, let's dance like Lakhan, let's dance like Lakhan. We have to dance to fend off the aliens.
Wow, you are, it's 2015, so that makes you 60 years old. I don't think you can do this.
Old is gold, and gold is easily sold. Remember what I told. Why is it so cold?
You know why it's cold? You know? Winter is coming. I think we should go home. Winter is coming.
Beta, idhar aao. Tumhare lakshan na theek nahi lag rahe hain. Tumse na ho payega. So, who is with me? You, Sardar Malhotra?
Hamari jindagi ka to ek maqsad hai. Badlaav.
Kis cheez ka badlaav?
Badlaav.
Ye to kya badlaav hai? Tumhara kya khayal hai sakti?
Very well, I shall fight alone, if that is what it takes.
Oh,
because it rhymes, right? Tonight is the night we fight, and tomorrow the sun shines bright. Add some more words ending in "-ight". Sorry, that was not to myself. So, come on people, come forward, fight!
I'm sorry, I have to call my girlfriend.
Even I need to call my girlfriend, not his.
Sorry, auntie.
Hey, auntie, kisko bola? Harry, you come.
Let me go, I want to fight. Nikal. I want to go, let me fight. Nikal.
Shut up the lights! Because I'm gonna bite!
Don't kill her! That's why it's her life!
Alright!
Thank you.
enough boss, enough. I resumed my conquest of this planet. I am the Dark Dork Lord.
Come on, Harry. We have to go fight. People, get in formation.
Papa? Yes, Harry Potter, I am your father.
No. This is Darth of the House Invader, first of his name, father of aliens, such as zombies, hunter of vampires, owner of the galaxy S6.
I I'm all powerful because I have in me the blood of vampires, zombies.
I am zombie.
Move. Let the Lord speak. Huh? Yeah, the blood of zombies, vampires, and aliens. Or oh, whatever the aliens have in their veins. And that is why I'm dark. Dark Lord. But you are unique, my son. You have my blood plus the blood of humans. That gives you the ultimate power. Power that you are not aware of. But I can help you. Forget your mom. Forget this human race. Join me, my son.
And made him realize his true power. He now knows that he was the chosen one. Because if the chosen one is from Bollywood, he had better be a 40-year-old who still goes to college. Only he can save this planet, because he is the one who is neither human nor non-human. He is half and half. And 1 + 2 = 2 + 1 because commutative law, which means if he bites back the zombies and vampires, they would turn into humans. Do to them what they do to you. He knew what he had to do. Bite back. Saved them all. All the creatures who tried to attack him started rising back as humans. Another apocalypse had been averted. Holi. And now it's time to celebrate because the party has just started.
Thank you.
backstage help, Divya, like kind of friend stage, but the script was written by me, Utsav, Aditya, and almost all the people around. He's our narrator, Siddharth. Let me quickly introduce the actors. So here we have Darth Invader, aka Dev Bachchan Khanna, Raman. We have Harry, the chosen one, Utsav. We have Neha S. Simran, the one who runs. We have Aditya S. Amrish Nath from Alok Puri. We have Sahil as Prem Khan, aka PK. We have Ankita Sharma as Basanti. There she is. We have Amit as Shikhar Dhawan. We have Avay as Sardar Malhotra. There he is. We have Naren as the zombie. And we have Ritwik as the MC. He did a wonderful job tonight as our MC. We have Shubhaditya as Vampire Pilu. We have Pratiti as the Count Plus Plus Dracula. We have Himank as the reporter. We have Shiram as the cameraman. And we have Riddhi as Riddhi. Aishwarya as Aishwarya. Preeti as Preeti. And Aishwarya as Aishwarya as Vampire Aishwarya. Kuch bol rahe hai kya?
Mangala, 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 Mangala,
Mangala, Mangala, Mangala, Mangala, Mangala, Mangala, Mangala, Mangala, Mangala, Mangala, Mangala, Mangala, Mangala, Mangala, Mangala, Mangala, Mangala, Mangala, Mangala, Mangala, Mangala, Mangala, Mangala, Mangala, Mangala, Mangala,